What's going on? You got RP Rock here, and today I'm back at it with another RP Reacts video. This time I'll be reacting to some of my COVID lifts. Now, COVID was a time when all the gyms closed down back in, was that March 2020? And I remember I was prepping for collegiate nationals. They were supposed to be in April 2020. So I was deep in the powerlifting peak, really looking forward to my meet. And unfortunately, COVID, everyone, like a bag of bricks, and all the gyms closed down. Early on in COVID, I had to get pretty creative in terms of just the types of places I was training and the type of equipment. And I think it made for some pretty funny videos that a lot of you guys probably haven't seen yet due to my page being smaller back then. So we're just going to go over some videos that I've handpicked for you guys, and you just see the conditions we were training under and make some comments. So with that, we'll get started. Let's see, this first section here, I was still in Providence, Rhode Island in college, and basically I had no weights yet, but one of the weights that we did have in the house was an 88-pound keg from frat activities, so I figured if the strongman can do it doing keg tosses, so can I. So let's watch this video here of me attempting a keg toss for the first time. So you can see there, I got absolutely no air time. Here's me weighing it after. And there's proof, that's 40.2 kg or 88 pounds. So there you have it. That was the early beginnings. That must have been probably right in March. All right, next up. So now a little context on this next stage in my, I guess, gym building. We were able to get our hands on some weights, just a few plates, a few dumbbells, and it was kind of the early starts of a home gym in my gym. I did not have a bar yet, which meant that we had 45-pound plates and nothing to do with them, and I wanted to hit legs, so I made what we would call a homemade squat suit. This is chaotic. You see all the duct tape? I had my friend tape me up in this. All right, let's see the squats. Added the front-weighted dumbbell here. So all of this work, all this duct tape for only 135 pounds of evenly distributed weight on my body here, but made for a funny video. So I'll have to paste in some photos from that as well, just so you guys can see. It's more messing around, but starting to fulfill that itch of building out the home gym. So next, one of the pieces of equipment that we got, which was vital, a lot of you guys got this over COVID, were bands. I think a lot of people had to do band-only at-home workouts. I was fortunate enough to have some dumbbells, and I figured adding bands to the dumbbells could make your 50-pound dumbbells feel a lot heavier at the top or whatnot. I think I had a set of bands going up to 105 pounds total. So I kind of divide that and have about 50 pounds on each side if I wanted to. So let's watch this next video here. All right, so it looks like we're doing shoulder press. There you go. And I got pretty much all the bands on there. This is probably like 100 pounds added total, so 50 each side. The dumbbells look like they're about 45 pounds or so. We're grunting through it. You can see that push there. So you can see how much harder that that lockout is when you have the dumbbells, or when you have the bands added, rather. Okay, so here, it looks like I also use some of the bands this time for some legs. And this actually worked a lot better than I expected. I figured a band-only leg workout couldn't really isolate that well, but just check this out. So I'm using bands only and doing kind of high reps, hamstring curl. Obviously, the range of motion could be better, but we're working with what we have using this pillar. Doing the same thing for quads. And honestly, got like a solid solid pump doing this, so we made it work. Get to show off the house I lived in college as well, which is kind of cool. But yeah, pretty solid set here. So now, next up, another leg day exercise here. One of the things I was able to do a lot with kind of minimal gym equipment is just calf raises. And everyone jokes around that no matter how many calf raises you do, or how much calf exercises you do. It's only really genetics, or just if you, like, I don't know, play tennis or bike a ton, you can really get some serious calf mass added. Now, I've conveniently cropped my legs out of this shot, so you can't actually see the size of my calves, but they are not the best. Here, let's check out the video. So I'm going up these stairs. I'm doing 25 reps per step of calf raises. So it's over like probably 300 or so calf raises in total to go all the way up the stairs. I might do this every day for like 3 or 4 days total. So really no commitment to it. But I don't think it made any real difference. I think I was very sore the first day and honestly got easy after, which I think that tends to be the case for a lot of kind of body weight exercises. So unfortunately, did not stick. One of the next pieces of gym equipment that I got was a dip bar. Now for this, I wanted one that I wouldn't have to install into the apartment, the house itself. So I wanted one that was kind of freestanding. And unfortunately, a lot of dip bars, or at least a lot of inexpensive ones, don't have a very high weight capacity. This one I got, I forgot the brand, but honestly, I don't think its weight capacity was above my body weight, which was around 230 at the time. So here, you could see me doing, let's see, 225 pounds added, or sorry, two plates, so 90 pounds added to my body weight. And you could literally see the dip bar wobbling as I go. And honestly, this makes it so much harder if the bar is not stable or even if it's thinner. So this not only makes it more of an impressive lift, but we made it work. So I'm glad we did that. And actually, you'll get to see later in this video, I reused the dip bar in a few more lifts that were a lot more interesting than just dips. We'll just say that for now. A couple months later, so this is still kind of late spring, early summer, and I realized one of my friends, also a powerlifter, shout out Anders, he had some lifting equipment as well. He had a couple of weights here and there. I mean, he had some sort of a bar, and he had a few more equipment you guys will get to see. So he was like, hey, Rock, like, come to my place. We're having some guys lift. And I'm like, all right, yeah, sure. He's like, oh, bring your plates, by the way. And I distinctly remember bringing my 45-pound plates. Now, he lived like half a mile away, but I'm like, it's only 45 pounds, bro. I could carry that. So I legit farmer's walk 245-pound plates half a mile, like in public, in hot weather, just to bring them to work out with them. Definitely a mistake in retrospect. I remember how fried my forearms were before even getting to work out in the first place. But let's check out these videos here. All right, so you can see we have a trap bar here. No other type of barbell. It looks like we're gonna do like some kind of floor press. So I have Lisa and Anders both help me out adding, let's see, weights on the bar. Looks like we're gonna try to do 225 floor press. And now, I don't mind the hammer grip normally for this type of lifting, but on a trap bar, it's just so much more unstable because the weight's distributed further apart on the bar itself. So. Awkward lift off. And you can see the bar is wobbly. There we go. Two reps. Nice. Three. All right. Four solid reps. And I duck out for safety, so that was crazy. The next one here. So, just for context, Anders, he did not have a bar. He just had his trap bar. And this random bar, which was like, it was almost like, it felt like a Pilates, I don't know what Pilates is, but like I'd imagine in Pilates you might use that, but it was like a practice bar almost. It was no real weight, but like you can kind of hold it like it's a barbell. And for this one, we figure, all right, it's a bar, might as well just add plates on the edge of it here. So let's all play the video. So you can see it's almost like an earthquake bar at this point now, because the bar itself is weightless and we have 180 pounds added plus probably a medium band, maybe 30 pounds or so. And we're getting after it, you know, it's definitely unstable, but making some good work out of it. Let's see the next one here. So now we switch the trap bar, and this is 275 pounds for, it looks like, three reps here. Now we're at the hammer grip too. I think that makes it not even more challenging or easier, just a different lift. Nice grind. Now here it's 275 plus 50 in bands, allegedly. Hear the grunting in the dingy basement. All you, bro. All right, now this last one with Anders is a home gym, a basement gym, I should say. This is a little weird. We were trying to use the trap bar and hit some legs. So for this, looks like we loaded up 275. I'll play the video. And I have the trap bar in front of me, so it almost limits your range of motion. That's why we're not really hitting depth here. But an interesting squat nonetheless. On May 18th, 2020, I graduated and I ended up moving back to New York City, and I moved into an apartment not too far from this one here. And it was the tiniest studio apartment you've ever seen, like a stereotypical New York City first apartment ever. But I managed to make 60% of the apartment by the time I moved out gym or gym related. So you guys will get to see the humble beginnings of that initial home gym. So we're trying squats here, and you see I'm using the dip bar. So I have to start in like a hunched over position, and we're still using that wobbly weightless bar. But I have some bands holding together, it looks like. Getting some solid depth. I don't know how much weight that is. Oh, I guess 185. All right, now wait until you guys see the re-rack. Gotta kind of sit back down onto this bench here. But yeah, that's what we were working with. Now here, another home gym workout. We're using the dumbbells. This is like my calisthenics era, I feel like. You know, we got each angle of the push-ups. I kind of like this one. I think this was peak creativity for the COVID workouts. I'm happy it went well. Let's see. Got the Pikachu shirt on, like a boss. Now we'll transition. This is the next kind of era within my New York City apartment home gym, which was, I was deep in the midst of ordering plates and weights and everything, but this was June 2020, and you couldn't really find plates or weights anywhere. On Amazon, it was all sold out or like priced at like $4 a pound. So Craigslist was the name of the game, which meant I was constantly just on my computer on Craigslist, talking to people, haggling people, trading eventually some of my equipment for their equipment. And the weights weren't coming fast enough, to be honest. And I knew I needed to get this these weights higher in order to continue progressing as a powerlifter. So what I ended up doing was I got two Home Depot buckets that were 5 gallons. And I filled them up with concrete mix, also from Home Depot. And I weighed them both after. I filled up the same amount of concrete, same amount of water. And they both ended up being 58.6 pounds. I remember that exactly because once I weighed them, I wrote that on the side of them as if they were weights. And what I did was I would add them to my bar just for additional weights. But you'll see how that went. So let's see the video. First, we're doing shrugs. And honestly, these work pretty well. You can see the back is pretty developed. You kind of have to have them, the weights far out to your side, unfortunately, which isn't as ideal, but for all intents and purposes, pretty good. Now we have it using for squats, which you can see was an epic fail. Look how unstable, look like I'm gonna bust my knee open just re-racking this. And by re-racking, I mean racking it into the office chair. But now this is the best here. So it's just bucket bench. That's like 322 pounds, believe it or not. I'll put the math on the screen. Solid rep.
Okay. I closed my eyes.
We worked up to eventually 362. Let's see. There we go. Push, push, push. Oh! That was a fail. I thought I made that one. I chose the video. Apparently, I failed it, so you guys got to see a fail early from me. But yeah, we worked up pretty heavy with the bucket bench, and once I got the real weights and added those on, 365 with real weights felt a lot easier than 365 on a bucket. So happy about that. Next here, let's look at some heavy squats I did. Now this is kind of further developing once I got some more weights. Specifically, we got these 100-pound plates off of Amazon, which, believe it or not, do exist. They were pretty cheap though, so they would chip often, but this is right when I got them, so they were still exactly 100 pounds. And we added it to my bar, which, by the way, my bar was a 25-pound bar. That was a three-piece bar. I had to hammer it together myself, got it from Amazon, and the weight capacity on the bar was graded at 300 pounds. And I routinely had well above 300 pounds, even up to double that on the bar. So here, let's open the video. Looks like I'm gonna squat. What's 405 actually? Sitting on the bucket as my base here. So start from that seated position again. There's so much energy loss just in that unrack. All right, now close your eyes in the depth unless you want to vomit here. Let's see. Yep, so don't judge the bullet wants to see here. You good, bro? Okay, okay. Hello to you too. No more. I have to film a video. Unless you have commentary on my depth bullet. All right, so as I was saying, the depth there could have been improved. Let's watch the re-rack here. Let's continue playing. Awkward re-rack. Probably have to just drop it onto the dip bar here. I'd call that two reps though, just because we had to do half a rep to walk it out and then half a rep to put it back. So we'll call it two reps total instead of one. All right, so now we're up to the point where we're gonna show a couple of lifting fails. Had many of these, but I think these are kind of the funniest ones in the home gym career that I've had. So let's play the first one. So it looks like we're doing a 315 AMRAP of sorts. Awkward unrack because of the dip bar. Blasting the Juice WRLD because I'm a sad boy at this point. And I failed it. No safeties. Still vibing out though. The whole house shake on that, so that was pretty crazy. All right, this one's iconic. This is, I'm trying to do 315 plus 105 added in bands on my bench, also using the dip bar, so it's super awkward unrack. Let's play it. Blasting the music as usual. Neighbors hate him. Let's see. First rep, not too bad. Probably shouldn't go for a second. Go for a second. Instantly get pinned. And just watch the struggle ensue here. Breathing heavy here. Just trying to get the bar off my leg. Gotta get untangled. This was quite the entanglement, as I called it. And we make it out scot-free somehow. All right, this last one here looks like just another bench video. So this time I've received the squat rack finally. I think it was a Rogue SMR, SM1, I'll correct in the text. Rack was like a half rack, so it's pretty solid for home gym. You know, it doesn't take up that much space on a footprint. And yeah, so now we're able to finally bench, and it has these nice little holes at the bottom of the rack where you can add bands for banded tension. So I've added, I think it was around 50 pounds on each side here. So let's play the video. It's 315 plus 50 pounds in bands. Got that first rep fun. Nice. Oof. I get pinned. Classic. So at that point we have the safety, so the pins are much safer. Not much of a risky lifting fail. And now last video here on the show is just some creativity. So I think due to the lack of equipment here, I had to get a little creative on the accessories. And one that I ended up liking a lot, which I used for easily a year after I had access to a full kind of gym, was just what I would call a plate press. So my friend Marshall, he kind of gave me the idea for it. So shout out to him. And we'll play the video. Normally, I'd recommend doing a much lighter weight, like 35 pound plate. But for this, I'm trying up the hundreds. Just kind of squeezing your hands together there. Gets a nice chest pump, but it's not really a full range of motion movement, but it gets the chest nice and juiced, which I liked. And my friend Danilo helping me. Shout out to him. So yeah, I mean, at this point after this, the gyms had reopened, so it became where I was maybe working out at home half the time, in a gym the other half the time. But I think a lot of what I learned just having a home gym made me better of a lifter. I think specifically the bands. Now my bench lockouts almost have no issues. Usually if I'm feeling the benches right at the bottom, because I think the bands added that kind of higher tension. And I think also I'm just a little more creative the way I train. You know, I'm not afraid to think outside the box. I've had a lot of funny home gym moments since then. I'll have to paste a couple of those in. But yeah, definitely happy with the grit that it gave me. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you want to see more of. Let me know what you want me to react to more of. And with that, I am out. Bullet is out too. He wanted to be in the video. So any words of wisdom to future lifters, powerlifters, whatnot.